Ladies and gentlemen, I have dire news. Yesterday, at approximately 1800 hours, terrorists successfully attacked our imagination.
Our imagination?
How?
The imaginary attack appears to have been in the works for years. The effects of the attack are so far unimaginable.
We've intercepted this videotape the terrorists made for broadcast. Luckily, we've kept it from being broadcast to the public. No, he's just a Care Bear!
Oh my God.
Later in the video, we can see another imaginary hostage. This one reading a forced statement.
Praise to the mighty Allah, whose divine grace and will have brought forth this day. Apologies. Now see, your safety is at our whim. This is the price you pay, America. You have defiled Allah, and now we shall turn your imagination against you. Death to the infidels! Can I go now?
Yeah, I'm in the cellar.
Could you get me out of here?
Gentlemen, the terrorists appear to have complete control of our imagination. It's only a matter of time before our imaginations start running wild.
How about this? You have that videotape that the terrorists made, right? Well, maybe if you did a background check on that videotape, you might find somebody who doesn't belong. Somebody who doesn't fit in Imaginationland. Oh!
Hey, that's not a bad idea.
Yeah. Say what you want about Mel Gibson, but the son of a bitch knows story structure. Get the videotape and do a background check on everyone in it. Oh, yes!
All the imaginary characters in the tape were identified, sir. Count Chocula, Cinderella, Snarf from Thundercats. But here, nothing in American folklore or storytelling matched this kid. He appears to be just some kid.
I want digital imaging and resource magnification done stat! If that kid isn't imaginary, I want to know who he is, where he's from, and who his friends are!
Yes, sir!